Hey, what's up? It's Jared with State of Tech, and today we're going to update a MacBook Pro to Mojave. So this is going to work for any Mac. It doesn't really matter what type of Mac that you're on, as long as it is able to accept this this update. And I'll provide a link down in the description below. So if you do have an older Mac, before you go through this process, you can check to make sure that it is supported. But Apple does a really good job of supporting much older systems. And from what I've heard, Mojave brings a lot of good life and renewed life to those older devices. So, of course, it's pretty easy to upgrade to Mojave. Apple makes it extremely easy, but there's really a safe way to do this. You want to make sure that you have a backup of your system. And just in conversations I've had with a lot of people, and when I've gone to help them with their Macs, I know that not everybody has a backup going. And what that means is that if there was any problem, perhaps maybe the installation didn't go through and you had your computer crashed or something like that, you wouldn't have a backup. You wouldn't have a way to get your computer back to the way that it was. Alternatively, maybe you don't like Mojave, the way that it performs on your system, and you want to roll back to the way that it was. You're definitely going to need to have a Time Machine backup of your system for that. And it's good to just be running a Time Machine backup anyways, because if you're a laptop, if your computer's a laptop and it gets stolen, water damage, something like that, and you have to go and get a new computer, or maybe it's an iMac or something, it gets stolen, something happens, of course, you're going to need that Time Machine backup in order to restore your machine back to exactly where it was. Apple does a great job at this. So we're going to look at that process. Okay, so right now you're looking at my screen. I have High Sierra running on this Mac, so it's been updated as far as it would go before Mojave. And so I have the App Store opened, and this is where we're actually going to download the new version from of Mojave. And after your last update, it may even give you the option to turn on automatic updates. So I'm just going to say not now. I'm going to hold off on this because we want to run our Time Machine backup first. So what you're going to need in order to do a Time Machine backup is an external hard drive to plug into your computer. Now, I've got a list of a couple of hard drives that I prefer, that I recommend, down in the description below, but you're going to need one of those in order to do this. So there are a couple different hard drives you can go with. The older style hard drives that have the spinning disks inside, which are definitely cheaper, and you can get large versions of those drives for a really good price. Or if you want something faster, you can go with a solid state drive, such as one of these Samsung SSDs. This is a Samsung portable T5 SSD that's 1 terabyte. So you're also going to need to make sure that the drive that you get has enough room to back up your entire system. If you have a terabyte drive inside of your system, you're going to need a terabyte backup. If you're on maybe an iMac or something and you have a 4 terabyte drive or something larger inside of that iMac, you're going to need a backup drive that at least has enough room to cover what's on your computer. Now, if you have a larger storage amount on your computer, but you're not using up all of that space, you only need a drive that's going to be have enough room in order to back up what you have on that computer. So to find out what you've got going on, go up to your Apple menu, go down to About This Mac, and then click on the Storage tab. And this is going to tell you how much you have available. Notice if I mouse over the gray space, it says that I have a lot of room available of that space. And then, of course, I can look and see how much is being used. And that's what you need a hard drive to cover. So since this Mac, I haven't been using it too much, it doesn't have a whole lot on here, this process is going to be simple. But for those of you out there that have been using your Mac for quite some time, you probably have a lot of stuff on your system and you want to make sure that's backed up. Now, one easy way to make sure that you're not keeping too much stuff on your system and that you have your important stuff backed up, such as your photos and videos, is to use Google Photos. So if you go to photos.google.com from your computer, you can download the Google Photos app and allow that to run in the background using your Gmail account or your Google account, and it's going to back up all photos and videos that you have saved on your computer. And it's actually free to do that. Google Photos does a light compression to your photos just to make sure that they're not taking up too much space, but in my couple of years, I guess now, of using that service, The compression that they add is very minimal, and the photos stay looking amazing. I've even printed some out after they've been uploaded to Google Photos, and they still look fantastic. So utilize Google Photos, it's free. It's definitely much cheaper than using iCloud Drive to back up all of your photos. That's another option with the Mac, is using iCloud Drive, and then of course buying additional storage from Apple. So what I'm talking about here though is not iCloud Drive. You can use iCloud Drive to back up your desktop and your photos and your documents folder and stuff like that. But iCloud Drive doesn't actually back up your entire system. It's just for backing up your documents. So in order to back up your system so that you have a way to completely restore that system should you need to, you're going to want to use Time Machine Backup, and we're going to walk through setting that up right now. So I have a solid state drive here attached to a USB cable, and because I'm on a newer MacBook Pro here that doesn't have USB type A anymore, I need this adapter, this dongle, to convert USB A to USB-C. So I'm gonna go ahead and plug that in, and then I'm ready to plug my drive right into my computer. Now, if this is a brand new drive that you've never used before, or it's not formatted for the Mac, then one of the things that's gonna happen after a couple of seconds of it looking at that drive is Time Machine's actually just gonna pop up and say, hey, do you want to make this your Time Machine backup drive? So we're gonna see that pop up here in a second, and there it is. So it says, do you wanna use new volume to back up with your Time Machine? Now it's gonna say whatever the name of that drive is, and this is gonna require you to format that drive. So if this is a drive that you've already had for a while, make sure that you have everything off of it, because once you start this process, it's gonna format the drive. And that means that your drive is gonna lose whatever was on it. So you wanna make sure that you're not using a drive that you've already been using to back up other files, or that you might have something important on. I highly recommend just getting a dedicated drive to utilize for Time Machine backups. So now I can choose encrypt backup disk, decide later, don't use, or use as a backup disk. Now, if you don't see this message pop up, it means that you have already at one point in time done a Time Machine backup. And even though your Time Machine backup might not be running anymore, it still assumes that you've got it figured out. So if this message doesn't show up, then here's what you're gonna do. So I'm just gonna bypass this by clicking Decide Later, but we're going to go into our System Preferences, and in our System Preferences, down towards the bottom, choose Time Machine. Now, I want to choose backup automatically, and it's going to ask me to choose a drive. Now, if you have a drive listed in here, you can click select backup disk and just delete the one that's already in there, or you can leave it and you can just start a whole new backup. So I'm going to click on backup automatically, click that new volume. I'm going to choose encrypt because I want this to be safe. What encryption means is that it's actually gonna add a layer of security over your backup, so that way if somebody steals your backup disk and they go and try and restore their computer with it, which would essentially give them a complete copy of your computer, they're not gonna be able to do so without this password. So I'm gonna go ahead and put in a password, and I'm gonna choose encrypt disk, and it's gonna tell me that I am gonna be erasing this disk. Now, as I mentioned, you want to be very careful there. If you've used this hard drive before, make sure that you've taken everything off of it and copied it over to something else before you do this. So now the process is starting, and it's going to go ahead and encrypt that drive, and then it's going to start the backup process. Now, if you want to know when these backups are happening, you can click the button down here that says Show Time Machine in the menu bar. So if I show Time Machine in the menu bar, I'll see it up top, and when the backup is actually happening, it will be rotating and letting me know that the backup is taking place. However, this is always going to run in the background, and so there's really no need to have that message up there. I'm just going to go ahead and opt to not show it up in the menu bar. I like to have my menu bar clean, and typically what I would do is have this run during a certain time. Maybe I'd leave my computer on at night once a week or something when plugged in, and it's gonna go ahead and run that. But the cool thing is after it's ran that initial backup, because the first time's gonna take a while, especially if you have a lot of stuff saved on your computer, the first backup's gonna take some time. After that, it's only backing up things that have changed. So the process is way faster every single time, and it's not gonna take nearly as much time. It will tell you on the screen after a minute or so of backing up the calculated time remaining so that you can get an idea of how long it's gonna take. But what I recommend doing, if this is the first time that you've done this and you have a lot of stuff on your computer, is just make sure that your computer is set to not go to sleep overnight, and it will just continue to run overnight. Leave it plugged into power and it will just run that backup overnight, and probably by the time you get up in the morning, it will be ready to go. In order to make sure that your computer doesn't go to sleep, go back to your system preferences, go to Energy Saver, and then make sure that you just choose prevent computer from sleeping automatically when the display is off. And I'm gonna go ahead and hit okay for that. I'm also gonna choose untoggle put hard disk to sleep when possible. I mean, that used to be a cool feature when you had a spinning hard drive, but now that we have a lot of solid state drives in our computers, it doesn't matter. So I just kind of set that way, so that way if I have things running in the background, I don't have to worry about it. So while it's doing that backup, and I recommend allowing this backup to complete first, but since I already have a backup of my computer, I don't need to wait for this process to complete. Next, we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna choose macOS Mojave from the App Store. So make sure that you open the App Store. If you don't see macOS Mojave showing up in the App Store, it means that you still have some other software updates that you need to run. So make sure to go to the Updates tab on the App Store and run any updates that you have available beforehand. I don't have any updates that are related to macOS, and so I could just continue and move right along. So I'm gonna click on macOS Mojave, I'm gonna click download, and it's gonna download that in the background. And so turn on auto updates. At this point, I'll just go ahead and say yes. Like, I want my updates to run automatically, so go ahead and do that. So now with it downloading, it's gonna take probably, it says about 8 minutes or so for that to happen because it is a rather big file. So I'm gonna go ahead and fast forward through this process and then jump right back into the update process with you guys. So let's do that. Okay, so when it's ready and it's finished downloading, you're gonna see the macOS Mojave installation screen. So we're gonna click on continue, click on agree again. We'll choose our Mac hard drive and then click install. We'll then need to authenticate either with our fingerprint or a password, depending on what's available for your system. And it's gonna go ahead and go through the process of unpacking the install file, getting it ready, and all of that stuff. So after what it says on my system, about 15 minutes, which anybody who's ran a software update on a Mac before knows that that can vary drastically. After this wait, it's gonna go ahead and require a restart, and sometimes maybe even a second restart. So you may see a black screen for a little bit. You may come back to your computer turned off, wait for a second for it to turn back on. It actually never will fully turn off, but that restart process may make it look like it's turned off. So if throughout this process anything gets weird, like it actually does completely turn off, go ahead and turn the system back on. If it's been trying to install for a very, very long time and nothing seems to have progressed, the bar is or something's frozen, go ahead and just do a force shutdown and restart. And typically you can do that by pressing and holding down the power button for a long period of time. The system will reboot and then it should pick up right where it left off. But this is where it's important that we have that backup, because if something does go sideways and our process of updating to Mojave doesn't work, then we may need to fix our system, and that's where having a good backup comes in place. So please, please make sure that you have a good backup in place. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and fast forward to the point where this is done and I'm ready to go. And if there's any more prompts, of course, along the way, I'll show those to you. So when the install process is over, you're gonna land on a screen that's gonna ask you to sign in with your password and then choose whether you want the light or the dark look. So I'm gonna go ahead and choose the dark just because I wanna give that a try. And it's gonna go ahead and finish the setup process, and then we're good to go. So I'm gonna hit okay on a couple little pop-ups, and I've got, It opened up my browser right where I left off and all that good stuff. So let's take a look at what we have here. So some applications may open up and ask for additional options like accessibility features. So if you need to do that, it's just gonna request you logging in here and it'll walk through those things. Everything differs depending on what software you're using. So I'm just gonna go ahead and approve those. And it looks like I am good to go here. Everything is installed, everything is working. The dark mode is kind of neat. It's gonna take some getting used to for sure, but I definitely like what I'm seeing so far. So anyways, if everything went according to plan, then great, fantastic. I recommend keeping your drive plugged in for that Time Machine backup. There's gonna be a lot of stuff now to back up, so you wanna make sure that that process happens again. If you did have any problems and something went sideways, you're just gonna need to follow the instructions. I'll put a link down in the description below that will show you how to get into the recovery area of your laptop or your desktop, whichever Mac, and then you can restore using that Time Machine backup. So there's a link down in the description below for that too. So that's gonna do it for this video. My fans are running, so I'm gonna get going here, start using this Mac, and get a little bit used to this Mojave experience. But that's gonna do it for this video. If you found it useful, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel here on State of Tech. We do a lot of content teaching you how to use your technology better, and we'd love to have you along for the ride. So thanks so much for checking out this video, and we hope to see you back here in the next one.